Like to call to order the North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission, public hearing, the North Canaan Town Hall, 100 P Street, at 7 o'clock. At this time, I would like to seat, get a motion from the board to seat Tim Abbott, an alternate, filling Frank Montaigne's position this evening. So next order of business would be, we have an application for a public, for a special permit from Joey Sage Jabanowski for a home occupation located at 84 Trescott Hill Road. Joey, Bernie, would you like to, you're both present, would you like to say anything? Present your application or review it before the board?
I'm not sure what I have to say, but I'm submitting the application. I actually had the home occupation for a few years at the location. I registered with the town for my business in 2008, and I didn't know that I needed to have a permit. And so now that I know, I'm applying for one, and there was an issue about parking, and we resolved that issue.
Just to review, we did receive a special permit application, and it is for a home occupation for a ceramic artist studio. And they have provided a map with a survey as well, showing the parking spots that they have available for anyone coming to the studio. And they have also submitted, and I think everyone saw this, but I'll pass these around, they also submitted aerial photograph. They have a brochure about the, it's called Funkware, right?
Funkware.
And I was able to see some because there was some donated at the library for the silent auction. But here's the application if anybody didn't see it, and there's maps attached to it if you want to pass that around. And there's a photograph of a drawing as well as a photograph of where they're proposing the parking.
Is there any comments from the public at this time? I've reviewed the information myself. I've checked with the tax department. I've checked with our town clerk and have found that the statements given by Joey Jabanowski this evening to be true. And with that, any questions from the commission? Okay, with nothing being presented by the commission or public comment at this time, I would ask the commission member to present a motion to close the public hearing for Joey Sage Jabanowski for a pottery studio known as Funkware at 84 Trescott Hill Road. Do I have a motion?
I'll make the motion, Steve.
Peter Brown has made the motion. Do we have a second?
I second.
It's seconded by Norm Tatzafall. Any discussions? No discussions. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? So moved. At this time, the public hearing was closed at 7:04 p.m. Okay. Next order of business is a subdivision application on Moses Mead Road for Jared Reva and Kurt Reva. Jared, you're welcome to present your application at this time. It is now, we're opening Jared's public hearing at 7:04.
I think Luke has started with the record subdivision map.
We didn't
better go get those. Yeah, they did.
That's right, they handed them in the office. I should put that on the record.
They are in the office.
Okay.
I saw them on the...
And Jared, and this has also handed in his green cards. Sorry about that. They are, the Jablonski application, they handed in as well.
Septic layouts, which Ruth also has. She has the application. She's looking to make two lots, brothers, my own.
It was one parcel altogether?
It was one parcel altogether.
And you...
My grandfather left it to the two of us.
You inherited this property?
Yes.
And at one time, there was a free split taken off the property, so that kind of eliminated that. So that's why you're here for the public hearing for a subdivision, and you're splitting the property.
Is even legally good.
Yeah, between your brother and yourself.
And the last item of discussion is the open space. The town of North Canaan does have a 15% open space requirement, and that was the last thing we were going to present.
And I talked to my brother about it, and this area right here is unusable. It's a hillside going down into a wood line that we don't really even own. So the open space would be in this area right here. I know it's not marked on the map, but that's where it would end up.
And that could be
a condition.
Condition put in that when he presents his final map.
Matt Schubert called it like an unbuildable or undevelopable zone.
Yeah,
so.
And if you could delineate that on the map.
Okay.
You know, we make that part of the condition.
We can make that part of the...
So that's what I got.
This has been an ongoing project.
Yes, it has. So you know what happened, obviously, so.
Yes. But I mean, we've spent a lot of time with you and your brother both in the office reviewing a lot of this information every Saturday. Any questions from the commission at this time?
I'll save mine for the closed meeting. That's just, I have questions about how we do open space here that don't really pertain to that.
Well, he should...
Okay.
The applicant should, he's offering it to the town, right, as...
Well, it's a condition of our approval that there be a 15% open space set aside. So my question is, that's permanently deed restricted, as if it were a conservation easement or an open space easement, so it runs with the deed. The town holds those restricted rights and monitors to make sure that they're complied with over time? Okay.
Or the land use commission.
If you do that, is there a tax break on that 15%?
There's no tax break if we require it. If it's a requirement of, this is my business stuff, I know it. If it's a requirement of the permitting, then there's no charitable component to it. If they gave more than 15%, potentially there could be.
But you're talking about in terms of a write-off tax
yes.
break. I think that you were talking about the property tax break.
That evaluation.
It depends. If he's deeding it over to the town of North Canaan, then that is, as Tim was saying, there's no break for that because it's part of the requirements of getting a subdivision. But once he deeds it over, then he doesn't have to pay taxes on that part of the land because it's actually...
Yeah. There should be some kind of give and take.
There should
yeah.
be, yes.
Yeah, he
there
doesn't have to pay taxes on that after he deeds it over.
Well, in fact, is he giving the fee interest or is he giving an easement?
Not an easement, no.
So but an open space set aside in this case is that 15% of the project is deeded as outright land of the town?
That depends on the commission. It has...
I have the exact...
Yeah.
Okay, I'm right here.
Yeah.
It's up to the commission.
It's up to the commission. You want to accept it. You can accept an easement.
Okay.
It is a deed. You can accept it any way you
okay.
want.
Because there are implications both for the landowner in owning land with a restriction and for the town in either overseeing that restriction or accepting land. The first one the tax implications for the landowner, they still own the land, even if it's restricted, and they'd have to have a conversation for an easement with the assessor.
It's very much like a right-of-way over someone else's property, they're still responsible for it.
Right, so I want us to be clear to the applicant about which of those two things we're asking for, and each one has a requirement. Yeah, so we may require the reservation of up to 15% of the land for public open space. And actually, there's quite a lot in here about what qualities that land should have.
Well, go back and find public open space.
It's a good question.
Well, see, he has frontage on the road.
Can I go out and just go walking across it because it's public open space? What if I get hurt on that land and I want to turn around and hold him liable for it?
No, not if he deeds it to the town.
So.
Is this what you're planning on doing, deeding something to the town?
I didn't plan on deeding anything.
Didn't think so.
Well, this is just a plan yourself for you.
This is my brother's.
So what I'm quoting from, which is here, is Section 5, Map Design Standards, 5.3, Public Open Space.
Get that shit off your back.
So.
Hey, I did talk to him about that already, so.
The fact that we have the ability to ask for a 15% set aside, there are other commissions in other towns that do that, it's a fairly standard number. But how that's set aside and for what purposes is what I was sort of getting at. Because there are different implications in each one. And the question that my colleague raised about, well, does the public have the right to be on that property or not? I'm not as familiar with North Canaan's language as I ought to be on this, but I am familiar with it in other applications.
My big thing is, too, is that, like Jared was saying, this is basically unusable, unsuitable land for building or even moving forward with it. It almost seems like it's self-applicable that it is protected in some way or...
Well, it's certainly not something that...
This is an old Quaker cemetery right here. And it actually goes yep. up past. So, I mean, if you want to start digging up bodies, that's fine. I'm just saying.
This gives it, there's a may here. So it's a requirement
right.
we
that's
have.
What I said.
We have
the
right
has,
to ask for.
Yeah.
I suppose we have the right not to ask for.
Exactly.
It does say public open space, which is an interesting term. Right, permanently protecting open space for public benefit doesn't necessarily mean public access, but that word I'd want a legal opinion on before we say
well,
something.
Most of the time that does involve public access. And you see, because it has frontage,
yep.
it does provide, there is provided public access, and it is for, mm-hmm. and in every subdivision regulation it says that. That mm-hmm. means that they have access to it. But the word may is in there, and
yep.
that's why I said it's up to the commission as to what they would like to do. It's a consideration, and it was something that we discussed. We went through the regulations, and it's something that's totally up to the commission looking at this piece of property. This is the opening of the public hearing, and it's up to you to decide. It's something that is pretty routine
yep.
in most other towns. They're always either taking... This regulation does not provide that you can offer a fee in lieu of open
right.
space.
Right, which is the other way behind it.
Which is...
And I got a question.
Can I ask a question? There you go.
Go ahead.
So your grandfather left you this land to you two,
yep.
you and your brother.
Yep.
So there's an inheritance tax, I assume, on the value of the property?
I believe it's already been taken care of.
But there is.
Yeah, there was.
And now, on top of an inheritance tax, we're going to take 15% of the land?
You don't have to.
It, does, no. it just doesn't sound like a good deal for you guys.
Isn't this just a plain subdivision? I mean, this has been going on since May. I mean, we don't have to ask them for nothing. Why should we? You're going to tell me you're going
you
to tell these people what, you're going to, what we want to do with their property?
I'm personally not saying that at all, but I am looking at
this
one.
This isn't a subdivision. This has been going on since May.
I agree with you.
All right.
Norm,
it's just a,
Norm, there's another way to do this.
If I was him, I'd sue y'all.
Easy.
It's pathetic.
Norm.
You can't do nothing with your own property anymore.
Norm.
Yeah, you're right.
Don't even tell me, Norm. I don't want to hear it.
Let me be very
clear. Don't read that stuff to me because it just...
All right. Then
the next thing you're telling me, the state of Connecticut is telling us what to do.
All right.
Get the man the subdivision. It's simple as that.
I'm going to continue with this, Steve, because
yes,
I think
please.
It's important.
Okay. Enough is enough.
And what I'd like to say is that this actually is something we should think about for future applications, because it says if there are qualities on that property that do meet these other things, they have real recreational value, or they are for natural, cultural, or historic reasons, then we may. What you've described, if I were making a list of what North Canaan might care about conserving, that land isn't under threat of development. It doesn't offer these things. So I'm not sure we ought to ask for it. We don't yet have a sense of what we would ask for. So it wouldn't be my recommendation to do it at all for this. But for that reason, not because I don't think that we could, under some circumstances, see a public benefit in that kind of thing.
We all agree on that.
Yes, so Norm, they agree with you.
We agree in the
beginning.
Thanks
for sharing.
We demand a subdivision.
Where's the process?
Anything else?
That's it.
You okay?
I'm a little scared myself, but.
Yeah.
Anything else you brother want to give away?
No, it's just.
You gotta go to the.
Any public would like to speak at this time, please?
Hi, I'm John Fasolo. I live at 18 Moses Mead Road. I'm an abutting owner to.
Hi. How are
you
doing?
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. I'd like to take a look at the plan and see where the septic site is. I mean, I know that there's a cleared lot.
You can come up and take a look.
It's actually marked on this map too. So.
Well, I think it's clear on this one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's you know where the clearing is.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. So I'm off in the woods straight.
Oh, you're doing that.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
And then the other one is here.
Yeah, because our house and well would be. Somewhere around.
Oh yeah, I hadn't. You know, I hadn't mentioned here.
Well, it's just behind the house.
Yeah, it's the house plan. And that's
a flat out wire.
It feels like the woods.
So. Okay. And that's what you said. This is our house. Our property would be on this side.
Yes, it's your house is actually probably right here.
Now, was there also supposed to be an evening out of the last space yourself and your brother? I mean, I understand that one lot was slightly different.
That was the way that Matt Kiefer laid it out, so.
Well, these, it's 14.845 and 14.851. So you can't get closer than that.
No. All right, well, if I can just say something, I hope you folks don't take some sort of easement away from him that he couldn't, that he'll still be responsible for paying the taxes on, that, you know, that he won't have the use of. I mean, I tend to agree with this gentleman.
Well, I think that's the overall consensus of this board also. Okay. It's kind of a something that's coming up from the state of Connecticut asking that we ask. And the thing that is,
well, I worked for the state of Connecticut for almost 28 years, and I think that the state of Connecticut always wants people to do something that they don't rather not want to do, and that's why I'm.
Are they taking care of you?
My union is not taking care of me lately. No, not at all.
But anyways, we should get back onto the subject
yes.
here.
Okay. So, all right. So, with regard to the impact on our property, if any, I don't really see anything that's of any concern whatsoever. So, were you planning to live here?
I'm selling it.
You're selling it.
Yes.
Get me some good neighbors, please.
Not I got you two good neighbors. They're from Cane Valley, so you look like, one of them. Oh, they know how to treat the land.
All right, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you for speaking out. Is there anyone else who would like to review the maps or come forward at this time?
Is Kurt, what's he going to do with his side?
I have no idea.
This is my wife.
I never talked to Kurt all the
other. I have no idea.
Oh, you don't know.
Do you have both their names for the record?
No.
Oh, good. You already
okay. And we understand Kurt couldn't make it this evening.
He was sick.
Okay. All right, and without any other.
Ask what size the property is?
You certainly may.
It's 14.
No,
14.
It's 29.
Yeah, total. Okay. It's 29.
It's right down there. 29.696.
And the proposed division has one as 14.851, and one is 14.845.
So let's see, about a little over 3 acre donation?
Yeah. Okay. Any other comments? With that said, I would accept a motion to close the...
I'll make that motion, Steve.
The subdivision for Jared and Kirby.
I will make that motion.
We have a motion to close from Tim Abbott. Do we have a second on that motion?
I'll second
that. We have a second from Dan Adam. Any discussion? Did you take one of his maps, or
I don't know. Did you?
I have one.
Okay, great.
Yes, I have one right here.
Did I take one of yours?
I have 11 copies of these. Okay. 3 copies of these. So you can have as many as you want.
Thank you.
Okay, yeah, as part of our discussion, is there anything else? With that said, those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed? So moved. Next order of business is the amendment to the age restriction on Blackberry River Commons located at 253 West Main Street. Bill.
Hi, I'll refer to Peter.
Bill is going to want to say something. I'm Chuck Rebberson. I represent Bill and Mel, the owners of Blackberry River Commons.
Welcome.
Let me just get a few technicalities out of the way. This is a rather large piece, so we had to get notice to 37 neighbors.
Oh, wow.
Here's a list of everybody we gave the notice to, and here are the green cards and the white proof of delivery. Some of you were on the commission when this was approved. I can't believe that it was actually 6 years ago, in 2006, that we came before this commission, and we had a couple of evenings, and a lot of neighbors were here, and you did finally approve this application for 21 units. I think some of you may have driven into the place and are aware that three model units were built early in the project, and one house for someone who actually resides there, who's here this evening, was actually built and sold. But due to the problems in the economy and the changing demographics, it's been 6 years and they've only sold one of the 21 units that have been sold. And we would like very much to have the commission consider and act favorably upon our request to change the condition of, well, it wasn't really a condition of approval, we kind of volunteered that this would be limited to people 55 and over. We just don't think there's a market there for that. We've had interest from a lot of people under 55. Interestingly enough, you'll hear directly from the Beezers who are here. They happen to be 1 or 2 years over 55, and they'd love to have some people there at any age.
Yes.
Bill is going to speak a little bit more specifically to his reasons for wanting to do this. I would just like to add a couple of things. So what we're proposing is an amendment that was actually reviewed by your attorney that has two parts to it. One is the obvious. We state we want to eliminate the requirement of having people only 55 years and older. And the second was in response to something that I think one of the board members here had indicated an interest in, and that was that we would not be renting the property, with a bit concern, I guess, that you know, you never know who you're going to rent it out to and whether they'd be as conscientious and as responsible as people who own a unit. So we were willing to also put that as part of our amendment. I know that the Beezers have some concerns about that particular aspect that I'll let them speak to. We candidly don't have any strong feeling ourselves, and the commission would like to have it. We can live with that, and we can work out something that would also satisfy some reasonable concerns that the Beezers have. We'd like to do that. But at this time, I'd like that Bill may say a few more words, and we'd like to be here to answer any questions.
Bill.
How you doing?
Good.
Nice to see everybody tonight.
Good seeing you again.
Thank you. Quite a few times. I don't have much to say. Just a couple things. I won't reiterate what Peter said. But the thing that I gave the commission a copy of the declaration, and I hope everyone had a chance to read through it, because it's a very detailed declaration. And it ensures that the subdivision would stay in great shape and be maintained at absolutely no cost to the town. That's the thing we want to say. There is a market for people under 55 that we've been approached on, and we'd like to, you know, we've been kind of suffering through this for a few years now, and we're asking you to see the light go the other way with that. And it's been a good tax base for the town. We pay our taxes. and the more houses that are in there, I feel it would just help the town in that aspect. The commission had a bit of a concern about safety. I brought the subdivision map, but one of the things we would be willing to do is to add a pedestrian crosswalk out at the end of the driveway on West Main Street, and that would be a crosswalk over to the opposite side, the east side of West Main Street, connecting to the existing sidewalk with the proper signage to ensure any safety concerns of people crossing the road to go in or out of the subdivision. I think everybody from Canaan understands the swimming hole that's out back there, and there's a lot of kids that to this day out in the summertime to go in and out of there, and we've been more than happy to add the pedestrian crosswalk to make it a little more of a safer egress or in and out of the subdivision. So, and if you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer.
It's just like the step up on the crosswalk issue. It's just that, you know, we're talking about that, you know, we're changing it from a 55 age restrictive on, and so we're going to have the possibility of smaller children being there, making their way to the grammar school every morning, and that was one of the safety concerns. So
one of the things I did notice with the town of Canton, I checked the school enrollment, and I know it hasn't been declining, so over the last few years, I don't feel this would be any issue with the school enrollment either.
No, I think you look at the school numbers themselves right now, we're actually kind of low to where we could be.
That's right.
Yes.
That's all I have to say.
And I just wanted to note what I just spoke about with the crosswalk basically was Dan Adams' concern in regards to the children's safety.
Okay.
Did you show that on there?
I did. It's over in this area right here.
Okay, great. Yeah. And I can.
And I just outlined the existing walk. I should have mentioned we already have in our approval to have a walk that goes the entire. As you build a home, you put in the walk.
And I can have that map for the file.
We'll get one better shape than that one for the file, unless you want that one. It's a presentation file.
Yeah,
hard to fold that one up.
Okay, I have a question.
Yes, please.
Yeah. First of all,
could you announce who you are for the record,
please? I'm Jeanette O'Leary. I live at 243 West Main Street. Mm-hmm. I'm on the corner of this partially developed development. First of all, I'm not clear of what I just heard. Does that mean that they possibly will rent these units, or is that completely out of the question?
Well, if I could respond to that,
you may
right now, what is currently approved, there's no restriction that you can rent the property. In discussions that Bill and Mel have had with the commission in the last year or so, they've indicated the concern that they have about having people, a lot of people who don't own your units who may not be as responsible. So in response to that, we agreed to propose as part of our amendment that we would not allow renting of the property. So right now we're proposing that the units would not be rented, but I know there's some people who actually live there that would like a little bit of a in-between ground, and I'll let them speak to that later. But right now, there's no restriction. We're proposing to have a restriction so there's no rentals.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and my second question is nothing personal here, but as far as being maintained, this has been going on for 6 years or whatever. It has declined. There's an empty building there with a broken glass door. It's unlocked. There's stuff stacked outside. There's mounds of dirt with weeds growing on them behind the people's houses. In my opinion, it is not maintained. The lawn used to be mowed fairly recently, and I noticed it gets mowed about once a month now. And I feel it brings our property value down, and I'm totally opposed to the changes. I would like to see something done.
I should.
They talk about doing things, but honestly, it looks awful. And it's you've got unlocked houses there with kids going back and forth constantly. Who knows who's going in and out of there? What's going on back there? I mean, it's just vacant property that's been basically left. It is not intended to.
Go ahead, Peter.
Well, I'd like to respond briefly to that. That's a very legitimate concern. Ironically, the more we can sell units, the more likely is that it's going to be upgraded and maintained, if not by the developers.
How are you going to sell units looking the way it looks? you really want to sell something, if I'm going to sell my house, I have a spot.
Excuse me, could we let Mr. Eversole respond to all your questions? And then you could come back, please.
It's an emotional issue, obviously.
I hear what you're saying, I don't blame you. I'm sure Bill and Mel will agree that they're going to do a better job in the future, but if they're selling units in order to market the property and to keep the people there happy and continue to sell property, it's much more likely with people buying units that that's going to happen than it is right now. We're kind of at a stalemate because we can't find anybody over 55 to buy it. So if you want to see that the thing improved, I think this change is going to move in that direction.
How much are the units? What were they originally and how much are they now?
I'll let Bill respond to that.
They're going to be selling for $300,000 range.
And what were they prior to this?
Over that, over $400,000. We have to get that range.
What do we actually have to go by? I mean, people promise us things all the time, but action is what makes the difference.
Well, and this is, it's been a tough world for us.
I understand that.
And we all know what the economy is, and in all honesty, should we have a little more maintenance? You're absolutely right.
Absolutely.
We're trying our best, and we're paying our bills, but we need the help to get more buyers in there. It's very frustrating for us to have people come in that are interested, and yet we can't sell them. And that's one of the things we would like to do, and bring people in there and be able, and not all of them have kids, too. It's just people interested in buying.
Do you think people under the age of 55 are going to have $300,000 to buy those houses?
We've had interest, that's what I can tell you. People have come in there wanting to buy them.
Okay, any other questions from the commission or the public?
I have a question I hope you could clarify. Did I hear you right that as you sell a unit, you would add the walk that goes with that unit?
Yeah. Yes.
Are these units then going to be sold sequentially, or will there be gaps in the sidewalk?
You know, you prefer to sell them sequentially, mm-hmm. you know, and that if you've been into the subdivision, mm-hmm. you know, you see we built all the left side up.
Right.
And now we would prefer to build in. We would try to steer the people in the right direction. If we found that it was built out differently, we would probably have to put the walk in if it was separated.
If that's something I'd like the commission to consider if we go forward with this, to make sure that there are not gaps in the sidewalk.
So make that part of the condition.
Yes.
And I want to say, to add to that, one of the reasons why you may not do that is because in the end, when you're finished, you get a much better product during construction. Mm-hmm. And that's why I said that. You try to leave it so when you're finished with the last house, you come in, you put your final floor paving in, and you're no more construction equipment driving around, and you don't have broken walks or chip walk or chip curb, you know, that type of thing. And that's why I said that. I wasn't trying to skimp on anything, just to make it look better in the end.
Aren't you still bonded on the sidewalk?
Yes, we are.
You're still bonded on the sidewalk, and his point is very well taken, because I've been on the construction sites of subdivisions, and if you want a nice sidewalk, you do it after they've dug up the lot and done that, and if they're digging up on both sides and you make them put it across those fronts, you're going to have equipment and everything else breaking it up.
Looking at the size of the lots, you probably will wind up having a 25-ton excavator there, mm-hmm. and yeah. once you put that type of stress on concrete,
right.
it's not going to last very long.
That's right.
Not to mention a lull, which would be a scaffolding lift mm-hmm. for the site carrying heavy building materials across. So
I appreciate all of that, and accept that from an engineering and design point of view, that's probably desirable. But I don't think they're going to sell 20 units in a big fat hurry, and I'd like to make sure that if they are able to sell them, and I wish them luck with this, that they don't end up with a partially built out subdivision 5 years from now with substantial gaps in the sidewalk.
Okay.
Well, it is bond.
That would be part of the bond. So mm-hmm.
I think the best idea is selling them, not renting them.
I agree.
That's a very good idea. They'll take care of it.
Yes, Mr. Beisner.
Thank you very much. My name is Lance Beisner. Although I was raised in Canaan, I spent a number of years in California and retired as a prosecutor out there. Went to seminary, became an Episcopal priest, and returned to Canaan. My wife and I, Ann and I, have now been there, been back in Canaan since September 2008. I arrived, in fact, on September the 8th of 2008. I know that because it was my 70th birthday. And And we have now lived at Blackberry River Commons since that time and feel just a little bit like orphans out there. And would very much like to see some neighbors. More importantly, we'd like to see a community. And so we're very much in favor of whatever changes might be able to be brought about through the Planning and Zoning Commission in order to provide opportunities for people to buy. We have one concern, and we have a very, I think we've done some very nice things with our home. We have the largest lands, and we've put in a significant number of improvements inside our home since we moved there, including both tile, marble, bathrooms, and that sort of thing, so that we have a great deal of pride in, I think, in what we now have. We understand that people who own property are far more likely to take pride in what they have than people who rent. So we are very much in favor of a community of people who own homes. On the other hand, as I said earlier, I am an Episcopal priest and I volunteer services at Gear and Noble Horizon. So I am also quite aware of how tenuous life can be and how people may end up having to move to a retirement community despite their best wishes to stay in their, what we hope to be our forever home. That we bought this particular home because it had exactly the criteria that we were looking for. That is a one floor plan so that in case someday we have wheelchairs or walkers, we're going to be able to get around and not have to worry about climbing up to the second floor to go to bed. But I know that as one gets older, it is obviously possible to find yourself against your own will having to move. Indeed, at Deer is frankly a grade school classmate who now lives at Deer. So it can even happen at my age. What I'm concerned about is the necessity from my perspective of being able to provide for our home if we had to move out and then had to sell it. And the interim period, because it can take some time to be able to sell your property, of not being able to have someone live in your property to maintain it, especially during the winter time. My wife had a home in the middle of Massachusetts, about 15 miles from Worcester. It took 5 years before she was able to sell that home. And in wintertime, it can provide serious issues of freezing and the pipes freezing and that sort of thing. So I would want to see some kind of a wiggle room built in to provide for the opportunity for short-term rental for humanitarian reasons. I wouldn't want to have, frankly, a community of people, of landlords renting out to people who themselves are not residents of that property. Because I do believe that it's a far better property if the owner lives on it. But I would like to see some accommodation in if there were some necessity.
So, can I speak? I think we're both, yes, very supportive of the idea of having no rental. That I want to live in a community that has homeowners. I'm just wondering if there's a way to protect that integrity and still allow some exceptions if there are the kind of a situation that Max was describing.
I was going to ask Attorney Ebersol a question.
Sure.
I've never known a Planning and Zoning Commission to have any authority over the ownership, the way it's renting or owning in any type of subdivision or condominium. Is that's part of your condominium?
That's really not
document?
Part of zoning. Mm-hmm. It's not part of our regulations to dictate that.
I mean,
to
I'm
be
asking you as a...
I don't think that the commission would have the power to require that we do that.
No.
But Bill and Mel heard us in prior meetings that was a concern, so we were kind of like volunteering it. Now that we hear these very good, thoughts from the advisors, You know, we're wondering, what can we come up with where we don't have people buying these units just to lease them, but we could cover a situation like this? The only thought I had today, maybe you have better thoughts, is maybe you could say that there'd be a limit of, say, you know, maybe you could rent it out for a year, and maybe just to two people. I know some people are concerned you might have 10 kids.
No, I don't think that that could be a condition. I don't think that renting or owning is under the jurisdictions. But I'm deferring to you as the land use attorney, but I don't believe that's in the statutes anywhere that we can condition that, or that has to be something private in your agreement that doesn't really need to come before.
That can be restricted in a deed.
Or in your declaration.
Well, yes, but we don't have any authority to do
that. I know that, but right.
It's really nothing with us.
We don't really need to discuss that here.
Right. Okay, then I'd like to unilaterally change what I submitted to take out the section that prohibited leasing. And we'll work out something internally to...
Working on that right now.
Okay.
You know, I can sympathize.
I lived in a condominium complex in California which had 38 units, and when I first bought, five of those were owned but rented. When I moved out, something like 75% were, and that was offensive. It was a very different kind of community than I had bought into.
It leads to declining property value, not so much as that, but I mean just the quality of life.
Right, absolutely.
Yes, I understand what you're saying there. Just wanted to clarify that. Thank you.
I have a question.
Yes, Tim.
This is a request to change one of the conditions under which it was permitted.
It was not a condition, if I can say. We came in with it, that was our plan. It wasn't that the commission said, we condition our approval on 55. We came in with our plan that was approved.
Was it approved with language that it would be restricted to 55?
It was in the declaration that they presented to the commission.
Yes, it is.
Okay, that's where I'm trying to go. So right. Just to be really clear, whether or not we had required it or you offered it up, it was in the declaration that approved it.
Yes.
So what we're being asked to do now, instead of both of those things, is to remove that restriction.
Right. The age restriction. And I believe, and I was on the commission at the mm-hmm. time when we were going through this, and we were saying, well, this is a good, David Soper mm-hmm. was presenting a lot of the information to the town. He had a parcel of property he was considering subdividing, and he came back and forth and back and forth, and then, you know, being in the proximity of Wangham Village, he thought that, you know, an age-restrictive community would fit perfectly in that area. And that wasn't mentioned as part of that Wangham was part of it or anything like that. It was just in the discussions. And they presented a declaration as such that it would be a 55 and above age restricted community. And what they, speaking with our town attorney, Judith Dixon, that she reviewed the declaration and she felt that if this commission removed the 55 age restriction out of the declaration, that the declaration would stay in place with the 55 restriction removed.
That's why I'm asking the question. So any of these other conditions we really aren't able to apply or not. This is an up or down question that doesn't change the rest of the declaration.
Right.
It just says we're comfortable removing the 55. So the crosswalk, okay. Do we even have the right to ask for
yes,
that?
Yes, that's a safety measure.
That's a safety measure.
Okay.
It's part
they're
of
offering
the planning
it.
Commission.
I understand they're offering, which is, I mean, I'll be happy to accept it. Mm-hmm. But what I want to make really clear is, are we
that's not
opening any other part of the declaration?
No, that is not
no,
part of the
it
declaration.
Not really opening
it will be a condition.
Okay.
A condition of approval.
Yep.
Not part of the declaration. The only part of the declaration would be the 55.
Yep.
Age restricted being removed.
Fine.
Dan, sorry, one more thing before you move on.
Yes,
I know you have, that there are concerns about children. We live in the largest of the models,
mm-hmm.
and we have grandchildren who are five and six, and others who are now seven and ten, and they come and visit. But they come and visit. And I can tell you that the design of these homes is such that if you had children of that age living in your home for very long, you'd probably want to go elsewhere. I don't think these are homes are really designed for young kids. There's one, it's an open concept. There's one great big room with, you know, that the bedrooms are off of. If you put those little kids in the great room, you've got to go head into the bedroom and close the door to keep the sound down. So I don't think many young families with young kids are going to want to live in them.
Well, I would like to go on record as stating this, that, you know, this commission is entrusted with protecting public safety and the property itself. And if there are small children living there and they have to walk to school, this is something that we need to address. And the applicant has saw the need also to protect its owners or citizens in their community too. So it's just a public safety.
No, and I don't disagree with that. I'm just saying, I don't think you have to worry about hordes of kids.
And I'm sure, and for you and your wife too, to walk to the playground with the kids.
The hordes of kids are coming on Halloween.
That's right.
It won't make it that far back.
They haven't yet, though, because they haven't found us.
Every adjacent street.
Hire another crossing guard? No, I think by just having the crosswalk itself, and this, I think we'll be in a pretty good position there. Is there any other comments from the public at this time? Any other comments from the commission? I would accept the motion that we close the amendment to the age restriction on Blackberry River Commons, located at 253 West Main Street. Do I have that motion? Commission member.
I'll make that, Steve.
Tim Abb has made a motion to close. Do we have a second on that?
I'll second it.
Second by Norm Tatzpahl. Any discussion? See, there's no other discussion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? So moved. Okay. This public hearing on the age restriction of Blackberry River Commons was closed at 7:47 p.m. At this time, I am asking a motion to close the public hearing entirely from a commission member.
I'll make that motion to close the public hearing entirely.
Okay, we have a motion to close the public hearing at 7:48 by Dan Adam. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second by Pete Brown. Any discussion? Hearing none. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? So moved. At this time, I'd like to make a correction in our agenda. The agenda reads open a regular meeting, but we as a public, as the public record shows, that this was a special meeting. There are several items on here that I would like to table for the next month's meeting, and one would be to review and approve the amendments in the minutes of September 10th, 2012 regular meeting. I'm sorry, I got the wrong date. October 9th, 2012 regular meeting. And to table the public comment part, and to table the zoning enforcement officer's report. With those changes listed, I would ask for a motion for a commission member to make those changes to the agenda.
I'll make the motion, Steve.
Peter Brown's made the motion. Do we have a second on that?
No second.
From Tatzpahl. Any discussion? Seeing none, hearing none. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? So moved. First order of business of the special meeting would be determine the need for alternates and seat them as required to determine the quorum. This time we have a vacancy, and I want to see Tim Abbott as an alternate for Frank Montagna this evening. Do I have a motion from the board?
Make the motion.
Pete Brown has made the motion. Do we have a second?
Yeah, I'll second it.
I don't know if Pat's ball second. Any discussion? Seeing none, hearing none. Those in favor signify by saying aye. Aye. Those opposed? So moved. Okay. First order of the business would be the discussion of possible action of special permit of application of a home occupation by Joey Sage Javanowski, located at 84 Trescott Hill Road. We do have a draft motion, which I will ask Ruth Mulcahy, our zoning enforcement officer, to read into the record.
Well, I was going to pass out a copy to everyone to give them an idea, because these are the same conditions that we've had on another home occupation. The conditions include, you know, all exterior lighting shall be full cut off. That's in case they have install any exterior lighting that might shine into a neighbor's property. The other one that we had, I mean, any of these you can take off or leave on. No outside storage of equipment, storage trailers, storage container supplies. And then number three is right out of the regulations. Retail establishments and warehouse are not permitted in that zone. And I know the applicants are aware of all these, that retail is...
is permitted.
Well, no, is not permitted.
Not the retail?
No.
Oh.
Retail establishments, like a store or something.
Right, but they're allowed to sell their own products.
Right, exactly.
That are produced on site.
See the application down here?
Sure.
Have a chance to the opportunity for Norm and I to look at it.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't get passed down.
Basically, when a letter of complaint came before the commission, we addressed that and went over what issues that were to be resolved. We saw the biggest part of it was probably the misunderstanding between the applicant and, you know, but they did register their business. They are being taxed on what they're doing there. They came forth and resolved the parking issues. So
the parking issues are resolved?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it will show right on here the three parking spaces, and then they have another one behind what they have.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just wondering if the amount of new parking is adequate.
Well, they indicated...
They explained at one of the meetings that you might not have been there that the pictures that were submitted at that complaint meeting...
Yeah,
that was a party. It was in conjunction with... I don't know if you went to any of it, but all the towns were doing an arts open house for all the artists in all the towns, and I actually went to some of them. It was really fun, but the parking was
just
hard.
Just a non-standard evening.
Yeah.
Right. It's a one. I mean, I don't remember them ever doing it before in the past. But Lakeville, Salisbury, I know that Sharon. I think all the towns participated. It was really wonderful, and it showed how many artists that we have in this area and the wonderful amount of art that is going on that you're not even aware of. And it was really fun. But I have to admit, I parked in some very precarious spots myself, attending. All of these artists opened up their houses completely to the public. It was fun. And then afterwards, I guess they had a get-together, a potluck dinner. So they were having a special event. It wasn't anything like their schooling.
It was fun. I mean, I think anyone here would understand
that
people have New Year's parties, funerals, weddings.
Yeah, it was
it's
really
It's just an issue if
it's
an
really
every Thursday
fun,
night
yeah,
occurrence.
All
yeah,
over the place
that's going to be the case.
Yeah.
I have a question that maybe we don't want to know the answer to, and there may be a non-issue, but are there any aspects of a pottery on a one-acre lot that could become a nuisance beyond parking? Is there fumes from a kiln? I mean, I have no idea.
I mean, it's been functioning since 2008.
And their concerns have been about parking.
I've been up there. I've never seen
fine.
So.
That's all you got. But, you know, they
In the complaint, the complaint was that they were running an unregistered business, which we looked into. They were running a registered business with the state. They were providing, they had a, what was, maybe you can help me, Joey, what do you call your...
No, you can't really do that.
Oh, I'm sorry, yeah, but anyways, I couldn't think, they have a blind there, I'll just call it a blind, and the vines grow and things like that, and the neighbor found offense to that, but that did not...
Doesn't relate to...
Doesn't relate to zoning, doesn't relate to the building issues.
Okay.
And then the third was the parking, we reviewed that, we found that, you know, that it could be resolved.
Okay.
And it was.
Did you want me to read the motion, or...
Yes.
Anybody have any comments on it?
Any other questions, comments, from the commission?
Whereas the town of North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission received a special permit application for a pottery studio to be located at 84 Trescott Hill Road, which included a map of the property, and whereas the commission held a public hearing on October 22nd of 2012, is therefore resolved, the town of North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission approves a special permit application for a pottery studio located at 84 Trescott Hill Road with the following conditions set forth to maintain the residential character of the neighborhood, not to be detrimental to adjacent properties in the zoning district, citing the town of North Canaan regulations dated July 5th, 1999, with revisions through August 15th, 2009, Article 1, Intent and Purpose, Article 6, Table of Uses, Article 7, Performance Standards, and Article 8, Special Uses. One, condition number one, all exterior lighting on the property shall be full cutoff lighting, and the use of freestanding light poles are not permitted in accordance with Article 7D, period A, and Article 8A. Two, no outside storage of equipment, storage trailers, or storage containers and supplies in accordance with Article 8C.2.7 and 11. And number three, retail establishments and warehouse distributors are not permitted in accordance with Article 6, Table of Uses.
With that read, I'm going to accept a motion from a commission member at this time.
I have one question. Bring back the question.
Well, actually, we moved it to a motion.
Go ahead.
We'll move it to a motion and then it'll be discussed.
We'll discuss it. Seeing that we have the motion, is there a commission member at this time that would make the motion?
I'll make the motion to accept this.
Okay.
The application.
Has made the motion.
I second it.
And Norm Tatsipala has seconded it. Discussion, Dan.
Retail establishment. Do we have a definition of that? I mean, can they sell pottery through the internet? Can they?
If it's produced on site, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, they can. Any of the.
It means like having a store with a big sign and. You know,
right.
We,
right.
And just, we haven't provided parking for that. It's just it's not a.
As long as there's the definition of retail establishment there.
Yes.
Well, there's more of a definition of home occupation that you can sell the items that you make at, like a farm stand can sell theirs, they can sell theirs. It's just bringing in items like, for example, like a store does, you bring them in from all over. They're not allowed to do that. They have to sell their own stuff.
All right, I'm done.
Okay. We have a motion made by Dan Adams and second by Norm Tatsipala. And any other discussion? We've seen we have no other discussion, except all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? So moved. You have your pottery studio. Congratulations.
Go.
Thank you.
Okay, next order of business this time would be discussion and possible action on a subdivision application from Jared Reba and Kurt Reba, noted, located on Moses Mead Road.
I have a motion with some blunt scratches about on it. It's I put in it everything as far as number one used to be about the open space, and now I took that off because you decided to make that hearing.
Discussion, yes.
Did you get one? Okay, and then the others are pretty standard, some protections in there because of past situations with subdivisions. Just to reiterate, I mean, we don't need to say all that about the erosion and sedimentation control plan, but those were two things that that came up in past subdivisions in the town. The first page is just the listing of all the things that were submitted, and if you go to the second page, it has the
conditions.
Yeah. The first page is just the what they submitted, what they're applying for, what the size of the subdivision is, the size of the lots, and the actual maps and who prepared them and the dates.
What does number 5 refer to now? Copy of the final easement, is that a right-of-way easement or does that refer to the open space?
It's this easement, they indicated it on their plan. It's an easement from one lot to the other, and the first time they talked about an easement, and then they did finally put it on the plan.
Yeah,
right here.
Yeah.
It goes from the Canaan Valley Road into the property that...
They actually said that they did have some sort of an existing road there now.
I think this road is...
Oh, that's over there.
Yeah, that's okay. Over there.
So
no,
this is
a proposed easement between Canaan Valley Road up to this second.
Is that needed for frontage or is it just their preference to have that easement?
No, they don't need it for frontage.
But I
guess it's... I didn't...
It's not something we're requiring, it's something they want to have.
All right, they put that on there.
Okay.
I think it's between the two of them. I'm not exactly sure what they...
Okay.
What the purpose was, another access. Maybe it's easier to access. It could have been an old farm road too.
Maybe they're preparing for the
future. It could be.
Well, it's two roads in. So how much could this be subdivided later?
Yeah.
They have a lot of frontage,
yeah.
And I think that there's indication that this is coming back next month for another subdivision.
Yes, I would think so. Fine. Since we have struck the possible open space requirement, something I support us striking from this, I do think this commission, and I will start by reading it myself, should think a little bit about the provision we have in our zoning that allows us to require that, and whether it meets our needs, whether it's something none of us care to ever see again, whether we've ever done it in the past. I don't know the answers to those, but I think that would be useful for us to reflect on. The language that I saw does lay out certain kinds of land that it might be in our interest to see set aside, but it doesn't strike me that we've ever been proactive about that or that we even would agree on what that would be right now, so I don't think we should exercise that ability until we've had that conversation.
Yeah, it's something we should review more thoroughly before attempting any option. Even in the future, we should spend more time resolving.
Have we ever?
I believe we have not.
I don't think we have either, so I think we'd be kind of
good. In the past 12 years that I've been on the commission, I've never seen any...
I don't think there's any subdivisions.
No.
There was 4, and that was about it over the 12-year period.
We're not voting on that tonight, anyway.
We absolutely are not.
We'll stop talking about it. We'll be here all night.
Go on. You guys know where to be?
Don't ever try
to
get
read this?
Here.
Do you want me to read it? Is anybody ready for...
Are we ready to read the draft motion?
Read it, please.
Okay.
I've already read it.
I'm going to let you do it. There's a lot of...
Okay. Whereas the Town of North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission received a subdivision application from Jared D. Riva and Kurt D. Riva for a two-lot residential subdivision on 29.7 acres with one lot of 14.845 acres and one lot of 14.851 acres with frontage on Moses Mead Road for Lot 1 and frontage on Canaan Valley Road and Moses Mead Road for Lot 2 with a 30-foot wide easement granted from Lot 2 to Lot 1 onto Canaan Valley Road in an RA residential agricultural zone, which includes a record subdivision map dated 10/4/12, prepared by Matthias M. Kiefer, Lamb Kiefer Land Surveyors, LLC, Salisbury, Connecticut. A cover sheet with soil and erosion control notes. Sheet 1, dated 5/24/12. A site development plan. Sheet 3, dated 5/24/12. A construction and soil and erosion control plan. Lot 1, sheet 4, dated 5/24/12, a construction and soil and erosion control plan. Lot 2, sheet 5, dated 5/24/12, a 20-scale septic site plan. Lot 1, no sheet number, dated 5/24/12, prepared by Peter G. Maddox, PE, 100 Hinman Road, Watertown, Connecticut, and Torrington Area Health District. Approval dated October 4th. 2012 for a two-lot subdivision, and whereas the Commission held a public hearing on October 22nd, 2012, it is therefore resolved the Town of North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission approves a residential subdivision for two residential lots from Jared D. Riva and Kurt D. Riva on 29.7 acres located on Canaan Valley Road and Moses Mead Road in an RA residential agricultural zone subject to the following modifications. Number one, the erosion and sedimentation control plan written on the plan shall be followed, and any requirement of this plan which proves insufficient to maintain erosion and sediment control during construction of the residence or the septic system shall be reinforced and additional controls installed to protect the town roads, neighboring property, and adjacent subdivision lot. Number two, all pins and monuments shall be installed before any site work or any zoning permits are issued. Number three, lots are approved for residential use only. Number four, the erosion and sedimentation control plan does not list the removal or placement of any earth materials on this property, and therefore there shall be no removal or placement of earth materials on these lots. A copy of the final easement shall be filed with the final subdivision recording map. The driveways shall be constructed in accordance with the submitted plan.
With that read, is there a motion from a commission member to accept this?
I make the motion to accept it.
Okay, we have a motion to accept the draft motion as presented by Norm Hatzball. Do we have a second on the motion?
I'd like to second that.
Tim Abbott. I second the motion. Any discussion? Seeing we have no discussion or see or hear none. At this time, ask for a vote. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed? So moved. Next order of business would be discussion and possible action on the amendment of the age restriction on Blackberry River Commons located at 253 West Main Street. You have the draft motion and prepared also. Thank you.
Make a counter motion. Might not too.
Yes, you can. You can add to this, but we discuss this before we even move forward.
That's a lot of information. I think we should have to digest it and preserve it.
Did you guys understand what Dan just said?
Mm-hmm.
He was mentioning that there's a lot of information to be digested and
absorbed. Yeah, I was thinking that this particular motion that's going on for a long time. It's been brought up several times, and I think there's a lot of pros and cons to it, and it might be in our best interest to go on this to the next regular scheduled meeting.
What is our time frame on this?
Well, whenever you close a public hearing, you always have
65 days to make a decision.
Right.
I just wanted to get that
meeting
for the record.
Is in what, 2-3 weeks?
You're not really voting on a plan or anything, so I'm not really sure. Maybe you could discuss it tonight.
Well, let's discuss this. And basically, the bottom line, I spoke with Judith Dixon in depth about this, and I really felt that she came to the complete consensus of reading the declaration of the Blackberry River Commons that if they did away with the 55 age restriction on this, that it would fit into the declaration that is one cord that could be stricken and allow them to pretty much stay steady with the declaration that they have in place, but there would be no restriction of the 55 age plus.
I'm not sure which one was on that.
Yeah.
I think it was, yeah, that's the same one.
Yeah, this is basically copies.
This was in the file, and she said that, but what date's on that? September 7th?
And when we talk about the renting and leasing and things like that, that could be something that is set up by them themselves. That's not part of a condition that we could have. They actually can inject that in their declaration themselves and move forward with saying, hey, it has to pass through their, most condominiums have an association.
Mm-hmm.
And it has to pass through an association's approval prior to renting the unit out. There's always those ideas out there. And that's really not part of zoning.
I understand.
Yeah, that's part of
understanding too.
The safety part they did address. That's why I scribbled mm-hmm. on here, because that had not come in until tonight, and they offered it. It is an off-site improvement, so it's good that they offered it, because you can't really condition an off-site improvement. There's much case law that shows that you can't do that. So mm-hmm. they're offering it, which is a big plus, because it's not something that the Planning and Zoning Commission can require. That's why the language was sort of, you know, it shall be pursued with the town of North Canaan. You know, I couldn't really require it. So now they've offered it. So that's why I scribbled
this up. I've actually gone down, you know, I've walked the sidewalk myself. They have handicap egress coming off their sidewalk.
Right. And I understand all this discussion we had about if we can or can't, renting conditions, et cetera, et cetera. But I'm on the fence on this, and okay. I personally would like the additional time to sleep on it, if you will. I mean, we have neighbors who are concerned, other neighbors that showed up as well, and my motion would be to table until the meeting, next regular scheduled meeting, where we all have a chance to consider the pros and cons of this in our own heads.
So you're making a motion to table this until next month's meeting?
I want
to
do that.
Yeah, you pretty much stated it.
I think that's probably the wisest choice right now.
Okay, we have a motion by Dan Adam to table our decision.
About 3 weeks?
2 weeks.
Till the next meeting? 2 weeks?
2 weeks till the next meeting. We have a motion on the floor. Do we have a second? Motion that does not have a second basically dies in house.
Yeah. But I had to throw it out there.
Okay. Concerns are noted. So we have a motion. We did not have a second on the motion. The motion will die at this point. We have the understanding of that of the commission that the motion is now.
That's right. Had no second.
Had no second and has died. Okay.
But just to be clear, though, the town attorney had no problem with any of that.
No, the town attorney reviewed the proposed amendments of the declaration of restrictions and dealing with both.
Thanks. She was okay with that, though.
The elimination of the age restriction and the prohibition on renting and leasing. Both of these proposed amendments would accomplish the objectives stated.
And then I would be comfortable making a motion that we take the guidance of our town attorney and approve this motion.
Okay.
Well, awesome. I think you just make a motion.
Yeah. So I will make the motion that you have drafted for us.
Okay. I'll second it.
Okay, we have a motion.
I didn't hear the motion.
We have a motion from Tim Abbott.
Do you want me to read it? I scribbled it on mine so much that I can't even. Whereas the Town of North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission received an application to amend the special permit approval for 21 unit common interest community to eliminate the age restriction for Black River Commons located on West Main Street on a private street in a residential district. And whereas the commission held a public hearing on October 22nd, 2012, it is therefore resolved the town of North Canaan Planning and Zoning Commission approves the elimination of the age restriction for ownership of condominium in accordance with the revised declaration of condominium for Blackberry River Commons located on West Main Street, subject to the following conditions, and it's just condition.
One condition. One,
safety measures for pedestrian street crossing on West Main Street shall be installed as shown on the plan presented at the public hearing.
So that's the motion that Tim Abbott has put on the floor, and I stand Pete Brown has seconded the motion. Any further discussion?
I didn't hear the motion. Just tell me what it was.
Oh, sorry. The only thing is, the only condition on it, I just read it in that we held the public hearing and...
Okay, okay, what you read it, okay, I read that. Okay.
Yeah.
That's it.
What we read.
Okay.
That's it. Sorry.
Okay, we have a motion by Tim Abbott, seconded by Pete Brown. We have discussion. Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed?
Aye.
So moved. Let the record show that Dan Adam was opposed to the decision. Okay. With that said, I would ask a motion from the committee to, or commission, to close the special meeting of October 22nd, 2012 at 8:16 p.m. We have a motion.
I have a motion.
Motion by Pete Brown.
I second.
And second by Norm Tadspole. I'm going to skip the discussion center and say all those in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. So moved.